Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to Rimworld, episode 4. In our last episode, we were still surviving, building up our base to be something a little bit more useful. And, yeah, we'll just keep at it. Apologies for my voice, and if I sniff, I'm 100% coming down with something. But, you know, I'll be fine. Just a cold. It's getting a bit chilly here at home. And I obviously didn't rug up appropriately, so let's see how we go. We have food cooking. Yep, good. Alright, research is getting done. Didn't we just get a new person? Is that what happened? Another night owl? Is that what it was? No, just going crazy. Never mind. Alright, what are our plans? Or is it this one that's a night owl? No. Fast walker, trigger happy psychopath. You know, it wouldn't be a terrible person to recruit that friendly psychopath into your midst. Sorry. Right, so, what do we need to achieve here? We established that a lot of people came from this side, didn't we? Cool, broke down. So, if we could get some stones, I'm going to deconstruct this. How many blocks do we have of slate? I believe slate's a pretty tough rock. 11, that's not very good at all. Well, let's bring in some more. This should all be slate. Because we want them to filter in past the machine gun nest. So we should definitely set up some sort of wall here. Steel wall. There's a bit of steel there, actually, which is good. Alright, our first goal might be to just wall this off really quick. How much wood do we have? Maybe worth doing it that way just early. A little bit. But, yeah, we'll chop a bit more wood. Bit away from the base, so we've still got some cover, but they don't. Apologies. You're gonna hear that a lot. I am very blocked up, which is why my voice is so deep and gravelly and sounds absolutely terrible. We don't really have any goals at the moment, do we? We're just sort of in a holding pattern. Oh, we need more stone blocks, for sure. Another 20. Obviously, it's not actually 20 stone blocks, it's a bit more than that. Oh, good, a psychic drone. Every colonist of the female gender, so all our females have nails on a chalkboard in their head. How serious is it? Medium, ouch. Oh, she's hypersensitive. And that's a man. 15. That's pretty bad, but not too bad. So Espinosa is our alcohol addict, alcoholic. She's about a fifth of the way through a withdrawal. So, from what I understand, alcohol... I've never had someone addicted to alcohol before. So from what I understand, alcohol is difficult to get addicted to and hard to shake. Not in real life, in this, obviously. Don't want anyone jumping on me for that. So in this, I believe alcohol, like, you need a lot before you become addicted. Whereas something like, what's a good example? I think smoke leaf is about the same. The analogs in this for cocaine and, sorry, crack and powder cocaine, those are a lot more addictive. You don't have to use those very much. go juice, it's like a military adrenaline stim in this, that's really addictive. Vivus, what is your problem? You're just feeling bad. You've got a mad animal, a tortoise. Nothing particularly dangerous, but it is going to get around a machine gun, so we'll have to deal with that. Do I have any of... Yep, there we go. So tortoises are slow, but don't underestimate them. I have had them easily peck out eyes and stuff before. They're horrible little creatures. We'll speed this up since he is a bit slow. Cargo pods with snow beets. Ooh. That's nice. Vivus is going to get in the way and get shot. This thing's been messed up a bit. So turtles are pretty small targets. That's why they're not hitting it. And they're terrible at shooting as well. And she's stoned. Is that what that was? Hang on, what does that help? Yeah, she's stoned. Cool. Wonderful. Wow, this aim is truly abysmal. Nice. What is your actual chance? 20%. That's horrible. We need to get closer. Who would have thought we'd have this much trouble with a turtle? A tortoise, rather. Unbelievable. Oh my god. Yeah, 2%. Because she's stoned out of her gourd. She did not expect to be on duty today. Seriously, do I have anyone else with a gun? Briggs, get over here. Don't cut up that squirrel. Just help us get this turtle. There we go. Oh my god. Finally. So now we'll speed it up again. We got two major break risks. Briggs, because of... no real reason. Aside from the psychic drone. Psychic drone notwithstanding. She is fine. How are you feeling? Well, things considered, you're alright. We also want to pull up the floors over here, because that's free steel that we quite like. So where was the Ancient Horror? Was that over here somewhere? There. That's the Ancient Horror. So there's nothing there. I don't believe that for a second. Penelope, can you come over here and just have a look? Please? Yeah, there's Ancient Danger there as well. Fair enough. So I'll just put a wall over there. Psychic drone's over. That's very good to hear. I guess it's here. Feel? Don't know. Semantics. What we're going to do, though, is deconstruct this a little bit further. I'd like to keep that plasteel inside, if possible. We have a raid. Group of pirates are attacking immediately. There's a few of them, too. Oh, and there's a piece of ship there. And once again, they are going to slip straight past our defenses. This is why we need this wall up as soon as we possibly can. This is ridiculous. What are they attacking? Wooden butcher table. Cooler. What have you got? An incendiary launcher. That's actually pretty dangerous considering all of our buildings are made of wood. So let's get them before they... arrive. Okay, you're not stoned out of your gourd anymore. Stoners, man. They're everywhere. Pistol, excellent. And Lovegood has a knife. So the incendiary launchers... incendiary, sorry. aren't a super risk to people. They're a bit annoying, but, you know, because all our buildings are made out of wood, that's pretty bad. The Molotovs will be a bigger threat. Fuel puddle. Oh, cool. I didn't know it dropped fuel puddles like that. That's pretty neat. We don't have another bed, but what I can do is put a sleeping spot down. Or actually, what we'll do is deconstruct this. We'll put a sleeping spot here, and we'll put the bed down later. Which will allow us to capture Paige before he gets set on fire and burned alive. God, that's a horrible idea. He's pretty messed up though. Death in 7 hours. That's a piece of ship that we rather want. That's a piece of ship we rather want. You are smoking joints. Did I not tell them not to do things? Social drugs. Beer on smoke leaf joints. Coffee, tea. I usually like to sell them, but yeah, alright. This time we'll play a colony of stoners. That's fine. That's fine. Who is our healer? Because she needs to get to work straight away. Lovegood, our vet. What are you doing? Feeding simple meal to Hogan. Can we get treatment on Paige, please, instead? He is dying quite rapidly. We need to stabilize him if possible. So you can see every little bit helps there. And now we'll get rid of the sleeping spot. Okay. What are his stats like? We'll just leave it on one. Prosophile and ugly. But not terrible stats. You know what? We're gonna try and recruit him too. The more the merrier. No hard feelings for trying to murder us all. It's good to see that fire is raging. That will be a problem. But hopefully we should have some rain relatively soon. Because there's really not much I can kind of do about that without devoting an entire day to stopping it. So I might just wait for the rain. Can you please pull this before it gets burnt up? A red fox self-tamed. Do we keep that? Well, it's got a name. Can it be trained? It can train to haul. Interesting. I always love having hauling animals. It's 3. What's their life expectancy? 9. So it's about, it's what, about 30 years old? I mean, we'll keep it. Sure. Why not? And we got the components as well. Sweet. Yeah, if we don't, something just died there. Oh no, it was killer attacking rabbit again. You'd think our cat would have learned, but you would be wrong. Where is our home zone? Okay, pretty far away. If we stop it getting through here long enough, it will just run out of fuel. Okay, we didn't actually get that. Auto saves. at this for a forest fire, though. That's rough. Honestly, probably should have stopped. Oh, there we go. So we got some foggy rain. That will put it out right quick. It's going to be a bit of an eyesore looking at that. You know, we'll soldier on. Where is Penelope? She should be working. She is. Good. Cutting stone blocks. Good. How are our stone blocks now? Ah, 490 slate. That's the stuff. Right. So I did want to keep that plasteel inside, but that doesn't look like that's going to be an option. So how about we just do it over here somewhere? Like that. You know, it might even be a terrible idea to, maybe not seal that off and put an automatic turret there, and have them, like, have to file past a turret away from our base. You know what? I like that idea. I like it a lot. What I'm gonna do is, instead of that, I'm just gonna put a little wooden wall. Like so. That way I'll remember. Then we will build another bit of slate wall over here. Just to sort of narrow them to only coming through this field of fire here. At least until we get sappers and stuff, and then that's a whole different kettle of fish. How's Paige doing? Not gonna die on us. He's not out of the woods, but he's alright. Oh, sorry guys, my nose is running like a faucet. I will be right back really quick. And we'll check that after I'm back. Sorry guys, I'm back. Right, we had a mad animal to look at. A local boar. I probably shouldn't have done that in 3x speed. Espinosa. Well, you have a rifle, Espinosa, so you should be okay. Don't even worry about butchering the rat. See how our aim is this time. Can you not run in front? Ow, should have been paying attention. Oh, what's wrong with you? Oh no, torso. She's just sort of stunned because of the hit. Are you even shooting bullets at this pig, or...? No, he shot out its right eye. Okay. I forget what I said. And it's dead. Excellent. So Penelope got a minor scratch. But I guess that is going to put her out for the night, which is kind of annoying. Sorry we're not getting a whole lot done, guys. I mean, we're putting up the Trump border wall. So that's good. Be nice to get that, some of that salt, which we will need for cooking. What's our next research? We were researching... advanced cooking. Yes, yes, we really want that. By memory, we were growing some sugar cane. We are. And did we? We did. We are and we did. Have a little bit of sugar. Is that right? Is it just 25? Really? I don't know what it's under. Flour. Sugar. 100. I must just be blind. Oh, I am. There it is. It's right there. Sorry, I pointed at the screen like an idiot. So you're cooking, not just a meal. I don't know if I like when they do that. Alright, walls coming together. We're also gonna, once again, pull up these floors over here. We pull up? No, because we got all that other stuff to do. Cool. Page's all healed up. Not very happy about his position, though. 79%. 99%, yeah. But prisoners are a good way to train their social anyway, so it's not a horrible idea to have a couple around. Just to keep everything moving. Look at you guys go. Alright, so this should help funnel them a bit. You know what? It's probably a bit of a waste, but I'm gonna set up another gun complex here. We've seen that most of them come from sort of that side, so... I mean, honestly, the bottom was probably a waste having two of them there if we've never had anything come from that direction. But it is possible that we will see a lot of people come from that direction now. Okay, wish I'd stopped doing that. And here we go, another raid. And... okay, so coming from up there, they're probably just going to come straight down here. Is that done yet? No. Frank, can we prioritize this, please? Are they going to... they're going to prepare for a while. You know, we might be able to get away with this. What have we got here? Oops. Incendiary launcher. EMP grenades. And an LMG. It's not terribly threatening, but it is a little bit annoying. Alright, so we should get the walls done. Will we get the complex done? Maybe? And the best thing about the gun complexes is they can just be manned by people that are not very good at guns, so I can have the gun people sort of further out, and that's the fallback point, is the machine gun nest, which is really good. If we have those sandbags up, that's even better. Alright, well this time they're gonna have to come past one of them. Might be worth keeping everyone out here. Okay, Vivis, you're gonna man that. Frank, you and everyone else is gonna be on the wings. Except for Lovegood. Sorry, why did I wake you up? Briggs is awake. Penelope's the other one with the gun, right. There we go. Which way are they gonna go? They're gonna go left, aren't they? Guess we'll see. And our colonists are not going to be happy standing out there on duty, but what are you going to do? You're going to have a mental break, I suppose. That's what you're going to do. Espinosa, you have really bad timing. I hope a gunshot to your leg is going to be the wake-up that you need. There are worse things in the world than alcohol withdrawal. We're going to hold fire for a bit. The LMG may outrange my gun, now that I think about it. In fact, unsurprisingly, the LMG outranges my pistols. Ooh, that was a direct hit. That's not at all good. That. Okay, this incendiary launcher just got a lot more dangerous. Frank, get out of there. Penelope, get out of there. Oh my god. Will you kill this guy? Okay, this is getting a bit ludicrous. This is not going well. That would have been a direct hit as well. What is your shooting? 13. You have got to be kidding me. Oh, I mean, set her on fire for sure. And you know what? You know, it's not going to get much more cramped in there, right? They're already pretty sardined in there, so let's just add more. So you died. Didn't the other one go down with a headshot? Is that the thing that happened? Okay, we just don't have anybody to think. I'm gonna capture you, but what did you... Shot in the jaw. Ugh. Gunshot to the jaw, that's not pretty. Alright, this is not looking good. Lovegood is our healer. Can we wake you up, please? And, you know... I mean, sure, no, eat first. Wouldn't want you stopping everyone dying on an empty stomach. Penelope, you got messed up, I'm sorry. And generally speaking, burns are one of the worst things that can happen to you. Again, in this, and in real life, I guess. Burns are pretty rough. You know, they're easy to get infected. They're very painful. And it's exactly the same in this. You are very messed up, but hopefully you'll survive. Or you won't. Really? People got shot in front of you and you're just wandering around. Unbelievable. I know you're in a daze, but there's being in a daze and then there's just being ridiculous. But, you know, I guess we better get used to it. It's gonna happen a lot. Till she kicks her habit. That she spawned with, I'd like to add, and now she's exhausted and starving. You know, if she gets hungry enough, she'll break out of her daze. Either that, or she'll pass out from exhaustion, or, you know, be too weak to move, and then we'll just take her into bed. I don't know what else we can do, really. Like, I give up. Who'd have known that alcoholics would be this ridiculous? Yep, collapsed due to complete exhaustion. She'll just sleep it off. Can we go and rescue her, actually? No. So she's still blue, so that means she's still having her, yeah, psychotic wandering. Are you kidding me? Oh my god, what an idiot. Quite frankly, absolute idiot. Yeah. Sometimes this game gives you the most, I don't know, suicidal colonists. Not suicidal, but it's like they just don't want to live. They're lethargic, I guess. And she's no longer wandering. Good. But now she's got an extreme break risk because she's starving. Yeah. Oh god. Espinosa, I don't like you. You are my least favorite colonist. Look at Penelope, she's... Oh good, and we had an overload. That's fun. Just fix that up. Quick smart, please. Did anyone else just see that? Don't give a fuck. That our cat just walked in and ate the meal for Glenn. And Tanya just went in and ate that one. You snooze, you lose around here. Am I right? That was pretty funny, actually. Yeah, and she broke again. Has she eaten yet? Okay, she ate. Oh, that's good at least. She's gonna be a problem, I can tell. We didn't even finish our research today. Well, this has been a thoroughly unproductive episode. Sorry to everyone who's watching this that thought something, like, would get done, but the Rimworld gods are not with us today. Unbelievable. I'm amazed. I have never had anything that ridiculous happen like this. But that's how it is. So thank you very much, everyone, for watching. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like button to let me know. If you want to see more stuff from me, my other Let's Plays, or more Rimworld, make sure you subscribe to The Aussie Nerd. If you want to leave a comment down below talking about this video or my other videos or, you know, just anything in general, I'm always happy to talk to my community. Leave a comment down below, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.